class, we are going to analyze clause number 4 of the book Flamingo, that is Rat Trap. When you see Rat Trap for the first time, at first glance, what are you able to think about the title? When you see it for the first time, you'll think Rat Trap means an equipment or a net to carry rats. But then you know this prose goes beyond that and tells you that Rat Trap out here is a metaphor for all the human beings. Like a rat is running for bait and get captured in that rat trap, similarly, we as human beings are running for baits. And baits for us is comfort, joy, greediness, and this materialistic world. When we run for all these things, we are trapping ourselves into a rat trap. We are trapping ourselves into the world. So this is what this chapter talks about beneath the surface. Let's just dig deep and let's start. The central character of this prose is peddler. Peddler basically means any person who has no fixated place to live. He's not having a permanent house to live. So he roams here and there, peddler or vagabond. And his job, what he does to sustain himself, he's involved in selling rat traps. He's selling rat traps to earn money out of which he is kind of able to survive himself. And then, you know, one day he was selling his rat traps. Apart from selling rat traps, sometimes he's involved in begging also, and sometimes he's involved in petty robbing, petty stealing as well. You know why? Because he's not able to sustain himself only by selling rat traps. So one day when he was going to a forest, not precisely forest, one day when he was having all his rat traps in his hand, and he was thinking that it's not just rat traps in my hands, but the whole world is a rat trap. And he thinks about this, he thinks of this philosophy, he thinks of this theory in which he says that the whole world is a rat trap. All the human beings are running for baits, and comfort, joy, greediness, all these things are actually our bait. And then he thinks about it, he was musing, this was part of his musings, and then he didn't give a thought, he didn't think about it again. And you know, then he was looking out for a place where he can spend his night. But you know, he knocked at so many places, but nobody was giving him shelter for that night. And eventually, he went to the cottage of Crofter. And this Crofter was a very kind and gentle man. He was a very benevolent man who actually gave him shelter, who allowed him to stay in. And not just gave him shelter, but also provided him food in the form of porridge, also provided him tobacco, also provided him, he actually played cards with him as well. This shows that Crofter was lonely and he was living alone. So this is why he entertained peddler or vagabond at his place. And they both had a nice time. And you know, Crofter has this tendency to share things very easily. And this is why Crofter tells Peddler when they were spending time together at night that, you know, I'm having 30 kroners which I earned at Ramstro's Ironwork. See, can you see that package lying out there? It's hanging out there. In that, there are 30 kroners. Okay, fine. The night passed. Both of them slept. In the morning, both of them woke up. Crofter went for his work, and this peddler also left the place. But eventually, after half an hour, peddler came again through the window pane. He broke the glass of that window pane and came inside. He stole that 30 kroners from there and he ran for his life. Now he's afraid that, okay, if in case he's going to take the main road, he can be caught. He was having this fear that he's going to be caught by the police having 30 kroners in his hand. So he chose the way from the forest. He goes from the forest thinking he's not going to be spotted by anybody or trapped, or nobody's going to investigate for that 30 kroners for him. And then I must say, Crofter was the only person who actually had faith in him, who actually gave him shelter. And this was a response of our peddler, our central character, to Crofter. He eventually robbed him of that money, I told you, apart from selling rat traps, sometimes he is doing begging and sometimes he's also involved in petty stealing. So 30 kroners has been stolen from here. He went to forest, and as soon as he entered forest, he thinks that forest is a maze, because you know there's no way out. By the time it's night, he's not able to find the right way to come out. Moving here, there, he got so much trapped that after a point in time, he realized he's going from the same place. Forest out here is actually kind of a maze for him, a labyrinth that, you know, he's not able to come out of it. He's not able to set himself free out of it. He tried a lot, but then he eventually realized that this theory of his, in which he says all the human beings are rats running for baits, he also thought that he now is trapped in that rat trap and he's not going to be free from this forest. Why? Because he has stolen 30 kroners. So he says 30 kroners is my bait and I was actually running for that. Because I was running for it, I became a rat and now I'm trapped in that. Why? Because I finally robbed. I robbed, now there's no way out, there's no escape from the forest. But then when he sits under a tree, because he was really tired, he has no strength to walk more. So he kind of sits there, and you know, when he listens carefully, there's a thumping of iron, which makes him believe that there's an iron mill nearby. So he kind of summons all his strength and goes. He asks for the permission. Finally, he's able to find that mill. He sits near a fire in that mill. It's a great respite for him, because you know the weather was really cold. And on that day at night, when he was spending his night in the mill, the Iron Master is actually the owner of the Ramsjo Iron Work. This mill is Ramsjo Iron Work. I must say, Crofter used to work here, and you can see the full circle is going to be made out here now. So Forrest, he went to mill to spend his night out there, and Iron Master came for visit, for inspection, rounds of inspection, so as to figure out that everything is going as per the standard. And when he came inside, he saw the Crofter kind of sleeping out there. And when he actually got a glimpse of the when he got a glimpse of the peddler sleeping out there, so he thought that this peddler is actually Captain Nils Olof. Now, who's this Captain Nils Olof? Captain Nils Olof in reality was an old acquaintance of our Iron Master. And out here, you know, because peddler was sitting in dark and kind of sleeping with that hat on his head, Iron Master confuses him as his old acquaintance Nils Olof and asked and offered him to come at his place. But you know, peddler was very scared. Peddler knows that if in case he's going to say yes, he's putting himself into lion's den, because right now he has robbed someone of 30 kroners. And he was thinking that there's this constant fear in his head that if in case he goes right now, he's going to put himself in trouble. So he rejects that offer. But you know, Iron Master was in no mood to take no. So finally he went to his place again, Iron Master, and sends for his daughter Edla. And then eventually Edla, the daughter of Iron Master, came, pleaded peddler with generosity. And out here, peddler is very much impressed by the generosity and kindness shown by Edla. And eventually, when Edla came, eventually Iron Master said yes. And they both went to the house of Iron Master. Out there, because it was night, everyone slept. In the morning, peddler was given a nice bath. Peddler was given a shave, a haircut, and new clothes to wear, because you know, originally he was wearing rags. He was absolutely in rags, which kind of suits his situation, right? But then at the house of Iron Master, he was given good clothes to wear. And out there, when he wore good clothes, when he came out in the morning, Iron Master was able to sense that out, he's not the man I knew. He has ditched me. And he asked him that he actually threatened him that now he's going to call the cops because you have ditched me. At this juncture, peddler says that I never said that you take me to your place. I never said that I am the captain. You are the one who forced me. You are the one who told me. You are the one who offered me that company. Now I am nobody to be blamed. But out here, Iron Master says you never revealed your identity. And Pedlo never revealed his identity because, you know, he was really afraid. He was really afraid because he was having that 30 kroners. And now, Iron Master orders Pedlo to leave at once. But, you know, Edla says, please don't leave because, you know, we guys, Iron Master and Edla promised Christmas feast to him. So, without having the Christmas feast, it's really going to be unjust. So, Edla says, stay at least for Christmas. And when Pedlo stays there, you know, for the very first time in his life, he's getting that bed, he's getting that room, he's getting a roof over his head, he's getting a secure place to sleep. So for the whole day, he's sleeping, and when he's called for eating, he comes, eat, and then again, he goes back to sleep. So Christmas went well. The next day, Edla and the father goes to church. Out there, there was an announcement made that a 30 kroner has been stolen from Crofter, and finally they both were, Iron Master and Edla, were in worry because they knew that there's a person who's staying at our place, that person is also having 30 kroners with him. And then they rushed back to their place. When they went, when they came back, they actually asked their servants working out there, and they said that Pedlar has left. When they got to know Pedlar has left, now they were all the more worried that he must have stolen something, he must have stolen their precious item. But then they eventually got to know that he has not taken anything. He has absolutely not taken anything. He has, rather he has given something, rather he has kept a rat trap for Edla, a letter and 30 kroners back. You know, returning that 30 kroners is a proof that our Pedlar out here is transformed. So this is a very important thing. There is a transformation in this narrative, and he realizes his mistakes. He leaves that in the letter. He writes, he thanks Edla that, you know, even if they as a family got to know that Pedlar is not a captain, still the treatment of captain was given. And now when he goes, he actually did one thing. He actually did a deed of a captain. He signs that letter as Captain Vaughan's chair, so as to show the respect that he was actually given in that family, even after knowing that he was not the captain. So there's a real transformation. He leaves without anything. He leaves that rat trap as a gift for Edla, for actually transforming a wretched being, for actually transforming a dilapidated personality who was really disheveled into a good personality, into a positive personality, into an optimistic personality. So this is a narrative which shows you that there is a transformation of the central character. I hope you understood this narrative. And one more thing I would like to say, make sure you read the textual evidences very nicely. You can ask your doubts from me. And for more such videos, like, share and subscribe. Thank you.